The project Crossing Boundaries is an Egyptological project in the best sense of the word, because it combines papyrological competencies in the sense that it tries to publish in the best possible philological way Egyptian papyri. It is also a project from informatics, because it takes advantage of the progresses in the digital age, in digital humanities or machine learning, to provide an enhanced knowledge of these texts. And third, it's a project in cultural heritage, because in times of open access, it tries to publish these texts in the most accessible ways, both for specialists in Egyptologists and for the general public.
The partners in this project are the universities of Basel and Liège, as well as the Museo Egizio here in Turin. Why Basel and Liège? Because some of the experts on hieratic del-Medina manuscripts are located on those universities. And the Museo Egizio actually holds one of the biggest collections of papyri coming from the del-Medina. And actually the core of our papyrus collection are the del-Medina hieratic documents.
I'm very pleased of this cooperation with different institutions, because it's actually what material culture needs in order to understand this difficult written material culture which has been preserved from the Medina. We need to address the problem from different points of view.
We're focusing on a particular group of papyri stored in the Museo Egizio, and we call them heterogeneous papyri because they consist of several genres of text. That means there can be a hymn, a letter, an administrative text, or a literary text on the same document.
We have many scribes in Deir el-Medina because it's a highly literate society. These scribes were multitasking, so they were not only taking care of writing papyrus about the administration of the work going on in the tomb construction for the pharaoh, but also they were a teacher, they were drawers making drawings on the papyrus.
And we have several thousand of fragments here in the museum. So what we like to do is a three approach system. So on the one hand, it's the Egyptological expertise, where we look into the palaeography, but also in the layout of the text, how a particular scribe used the arrangement of the document. So for example, you have a very neat person who organized this document in a very structured way. Then you have a more chaotic type of scribe who did very circles and adding information here and there. That's one option to go forward in puzzling together pieces.
It happens sometimes that the text is very badly written, and to read the text you can have different solutions. If you can identify the type of text it is, for instance, if you can recognize a letter or an administrative text, a contract, and so on, you might expect to find the formulas, certain phraseology. From one or two signs, you can retrieve complete sequences.
Well, there are gentlemen at Deir el-Medina who employ a handwriting that's rather hard to decipher. And in that case, if you, well, you're dealing with fragments, it only helps you to read other texts that are better preserved and look for similarities, and then try to make your way.
In order that the scholars actually can study our material, the papyri have to be restored and consolidated before. After restoration, after they were put between class, they would be scanned and uploaded in the database, and then scholars actually can start to study the texts.
In my research project, I'm planning to use current machine learning techniques to help classify papyrus fragments, to find joints between them, and thus to reconstruct the whole document.
Well, now we are in the middle of the digital revolution. We can say that we are already now in a digital era, and we can take advantage of all the different tools which will enhance our efforts and accelerate all we do in order to reconstruct the text that the ancient scribes has left to us.